through boughs of weeping willows I see. Through cracks and wooden slats of shack housing I see. Through factory steam and junkyard dust, fire hydrant water, hospital gowns, crowded dance floors and athletic TV screens, I see. Through slave ships and radio waves, religious fog and graveyard dirt, I see you. When I was a boy, they called me that. And as I grew, they called me that and worse. The word black hung from tongues like thick brown sap, dripped through lips like loose meat, shook from fingertips, pounded from fists, or hovered in the air like police helicopters. Black was always shit and rotten. Stop acting black! It was never sweet. It was never rich. It was never universal or outer space. It was never onyx and oil and diamond dust and white. It was always snow, always pure. It was never smoke or smog or blinding or plain. It was always light and good, not dark and bad like dirt. They say there are places in Africa where the dirt is so black, so dark, so rich that anything can grow in it, and that's what I want to be. That's what culture means, isn't it? A place where things can grow? I want to be that. I want to be diamond-dusted cardboard creases, black as the innermost core of the earth, dark as a math class blackboard, that expensive space where some of our first problems were solved. I want to be that black. I want to be dark as the cool shade you seek when the bright white light is just too hot. I want to be black as Michael Jordan's head cutting through the sky, leaving not a trace black. As Marley's hair whipping like dread, locked in a cage of angry bones, spinning round and round and round and round to redemption songs of fire. I want to be black as Paul Robeson, the day he broke the race barrier at Rutgers, sang opera, yet never turned his back on us, who learned how to speak 12 languages fluently so that he could hear his way through the world, come back and teach us so-called darkies and white trash, the things that are being done in all our names. I want to be that black. I want to be Claude McKay black, Elijah McCoy, Benjamin Banneker black. I want to be Nina Simone, Tracy Chapman black. I want to be Coltrane black. I want to be Dreadlock black, Sapphire black, Nat Turner, Malcolm X, Frederick Douglass black. I want to be Harriet Tubman Tough, CLR James, James Baldwin, Mayor Rustin black. I want to be, how's it going, brother? What up, sister, black? I want to be Langston Hughes. I want to be Michael Jackson black. I wrote this poem 6 years ago, and then used to get a different response. Yeah. Yeah, I said it. Because Mike was so black, he danced and sang and performed so hard, I'm telling y'all, it fell off. My grandmother had the same skin disease as Mike when she passed, as for the rest of that mess that came from Mike's father, who himself was a black man in a steel town in a racist country that would not let him vote. Was he a motherfucker? Hell yeah. But what was going on in Papa Joe Jackson's American life that made him make his children dance while he whipped them with the belt? I am Michael Jackson black because I can understand how insane this world can make you feel. When I was a boy, they called me that. And as I grew, they called me that and worse. Some black children wanted to cut me to see if my blood was black. They did. It was. I am. So I've been working on a book of poetry about the life and career of Michael Jackson and his family, and his dynastic family. And I think that he's an interesting figure to write about. He was a hero of mine from a very young age. But discussing Michael Jackson means discussing questions of race, of gender, of sexuality, of poverty, of stardom, of youth, all of these things, of justice, all of these things. So I just think he is obviously like most people in the world, but I mean, it's not saying much to say what an amazing individual he was. I want to, and contradictory as well. But I think mostly This is Mary Monroe home and the end of the song. This is called Moonwalking. Why did I leave Earth? Because it's crazy down there, but not crazy enough. I dance it all away. I'm so gone. I walk backwards and still outmove you. I glide, receding toward innocence, back to childhood. I'm a star, suspended, floating like a god or a king. No, too young to be king, a prince. I used to be a robot, but robots move too slowly, too earthbound, and I'm unable to be smooth. I'm soft, like the dust I kick up when I spin. Dust some color no one's ever seen before. My dirt is your souvenir. John Merrick's bones. I built fortresses from Ferris wheels. Climbed giant bonsais with chimpanzees, higher than you could imagine. Into the air, thinner than me. Have you heard the sounds I make? Out of this world, how many millions does it take to prove? Earthlings can't move like me. Adults can't touch me. I walk backwards on another planet, singing, and still leave you in my dust. Climbing, morphing into a whole other dimension. One small step for man, one giant step for me. On my platform, poised for takeoff. I won't move until you scream me into motion. I am one glove, my other hand, invisible. If not for this coat of metals, these rhinestone socks, shining pants, you would not see me. A ball of light, slowly fading. I can't breathe your air. I'm terrified of your sun. I can't stop dancing. I don't understand your laws. I certainly can't obey these laws. Gravity? Be serious. Have you seen me move?
Change his ways, and no message could have been any clearer. But if you want to make the world